Welcome. My name is Marc Shipman-Mueller, and I'm a product manager at ARRI. You're watching one in a series of ARRI Tech Talks on the Alexa 35 camera. I'm assuming that you already watched the Alexa 35 guided tour video to get an overview of the camera. If you have not, please do so, because in this video here, we will go into more detail, specifically about the Alexa 35 image quality. So what is the purpose of the camera? The purpose of a camera is to create images. And here at ARRI, our main goal has always been to create the best overall image quality with all the cameras we create. With this new camera, the Alexa 35, we've not only created a new sensor, but we've also completely overhauled our image science. As a result, the new camera has a significantly better image quality than all our previous cameras. The camera provides more dynamic range, more contrast, more sensitivity, and more colors. Let's look at each one of those in detail. We have a new sensor. It's a native 4K sensor with a 4.6K horizontal photosite count, and the sensor runs up to 120 frames per second. But the really exciting thing about the sensor is the high dynamic range. This sensor has a dynamic range of 17 stops, which is 2.5 stops more than, for instance, with an Alexa Mini, and certainly more than with any other camera we've ever measured. This great dynamic range gives you fantastic advantage. 17 stops of dynamic range allow you to handle any situation on the set. It gives you increased flexibility in post, and these images are the best source for any high dynamic range project. So when we fired up the new sensor and looked at it for the first time, we saw that it had a fantastic dynamic range, and we did a little happy dance in the lab. There was a big party in the lab. But then when we looked closer, we noticed that in the dark parts of the image, they weren't really dark. They were kind of gray and milky. Turns out, with 17 stops of dynamic range, you have to be really, really careful about stray light. And we found that there's some stray light between the lens and the sensor inside the camera. To combat that, we developed a sophisticated stray light suppression technology that works in the camera and in the lens mounts. Because of that, the Alexa 35 can capture the full contrast range and character of each lens and create deep and rich blacks. Now, the stray light suppression in the camera will help with any lens and lens mount combination. But for the absolute best contrast, you can use one of 5 stray light optimized lens mounts from ARRI. There's the existing LPL mount with the L-bus connector, the existing PL to LPL adapter, the existing ARRI EF mount with the L-bus connector, and then there are 2 new ARRI PL mounts, one with an L-bus and one with a Hirose connector. The interface between lens mount and camera is the same as on the Mini LF and the Alexa Mini, so you could theoretically use all the older lens mounts, but we recommend to use the stray light optimized lens mounts. Let's talk about the sensitivity of the camera. We consider the Alexa 35 to be a high ISO camera because it has lower noise than any of our previous cameras. This allows us to provide you with exposure index 160 to exposure index 6400 in the camera. We also have an optional enhanced sensitivity mode that gives you even cleaner images in low light. This is available from exposure index 2560 to 6400, and it's an in-camera process, so it's baked into the ARRI RAW and into the ProRes. There are also some frame rate and shutter limitations, which you can see in the table here. We've done a major overhaul of the ARRI color science. This is based on in-depth discussions with cinematographers, with colorists, and with post-production supervisors. We examined every step in the image processing chain and did a whole bunch of experiments. Because it turns out, you can't just come up with this stuff in the lab. You have to come up with new ideas and then test them, show them to colorists, show them to cinematographers, and use their feedback to then improve again and continue this feedback loop. The end result is a new color science that we call the reveal color science. It's called reveal color science because it reveals more of what is in the image. Reveal color science is used in the camera to create the ProRes image, to create the viewfinder image, the SDI outputs, and the frame grabs, but it's also available through leading third-party software tool providers in order to process ARRI RAW. You have to distinguish between the Alexa 35 camera-specific features, like the sensor that provides the dynamic range, the ARRI textures for new creative options, and the advanced color match that makes all Alexa 35 cameras look the same, and what's in the reveal color signs. Now, there are six components to the reveal color signs. Let's look at those individually. First, we have a new Debayer algorithm. What does that do? It converts the ARRI raw into RGB image data. This new Debayer algorithm is a lot more powerful, and we can run it in the Alexa 35 because the camera has a lot more processing power. This new Debayer algorithm provides cleaner images with cleaner edges, which is great for blue screen and green screen compositing. Second, we have a new color engine. This color engine transforms RGB image data into the camera color space. The new color engine provides more accurate color reproduction. This means more pleasing and natural skin tones. It means better color tracking across exposure levels. It means greatly improved saturated colors, such as brake lights at night or neon signs, and a better color differentiation, even in low-key scenes. You can capture even very subtle tones with great color. Third, we have a new camera color space. We found this through a lot of experiments where we showed images to colorists in different color spaces to see which images are easier and which are harder to grade. This new color space, you would think it has to be as big as possible, but that's not true. It has to be just the right size. The new color space is larger than Rec 2020, which is the largest display color space in existence, but it's also not so big that you run into virtual colors, which are colors outside of the human visible spectrum. With this new color space, you can do faster grading, you have easier color space conversion, and the new color space is completely enclosed and therefore compatible with ACES. And fourth, we have a new log-C tonal curve. For 12 years, we have the log-C curve. This is technically the third generation of our log curve, so I'm going to call it log-C3 here now. And the log-C3 curve has been fantastic, and it's been really great at containing the 14.5 stops of dynamic range of all our previous cameras. With the Alexa 35, we have 17 stops of dynamic range, so we needed a new log-C curve to contain all that dynamic range. The new log-C4 curve does that. Now, because it contains the higher dynamic range, when you look at 18% gray, it actually looks darker than it does on log-C3. Don't let that freak you out. That is normal. Fifth, we have new lookup tables that convert the log-C4 image into the display color spaces. And you need these new lookup tables. We've created these new lookup tables to take full advantage of the new sensor, of the new camera color space, and of the log-C4 tonal curve. Using these ARRI log-C4 lookup tables provides best shadow tonality and better color fidelity, and it really is the best basis for color grading. When you work in log-C4, you must use these new lookup tables as a basis for your grade, because you can't really do it manually anymore, as some people have done with the log-C3 curve. Here you see two images captured in ARRI RAW with the Alexa Mini LF. The one on the left is log-C3, the one on the right is log-C4. You'll notice how the one on the right is darker. That is normal. Because once we're using the proper lookup tables, we can transform each of these images to Rec. 709 and both come out fine. Last but not least, we have backwards compatibility. We always try to make sure that the images from our latest camera can be intercut with our previous cameras. So the images from the Alexa 35 can be intercut with the previous Alexa or Amira images. But even better, ARRI RAW images from the Mini LF and the Alexa LF can also be processed with the new reveal color signs. You won't get the increased dynamic range, and you won't get the ARRI textures, but you will get cleaner edges because of the new debayering. You get more accurate color reproduction because of the new color engine. You'll get easier grading and full compatibility with ACES because of the new native color space. And you get compatibility with the Alexa 35 workflow through the new log-C4 tonal curve. And then, of course, you get the improved color fidelity through the new lookup tables. So to summarize, with the Alexa 35, we have raised the bar on image quality with more dynamic range, more contrast, more sensitivity, and more colors. And we can't wait to see what cool images you will shoot with the Alexa 35. Thank you so much for watching.